Welcome to Bloodbath & Beyond. Today we review The Endless. Skip the Kool-Aid, grab a cold one.
Directed by and starring Aaron Moorhead and Justin Benson, and co-starring Callie Hernandez and Tate Ellington, this movie's about two brothers who survived a UFO death cult. They escaped, and after receiving a mysterious videotape 10 years later, they've decided to return to the camp and figure out what's really happening. This is actually a recommendation from Patreon, Maddie, aka Tipsy Nerd, a mod for my Twitch channel, actually. He won the monthly movie raffle the first month he signed up. This is actually one that was on our list anyway, so two birds. So if you guys are unfamiliar, this is from the same team that brought us Spring and Resolution. And Resolution is kind of, I think they might all be in the same universe, but Resolution definitely is in the same universe as The Endless. So thank you again, Tipsy, I appreciate it. Now what do we like?
I absolutely loved the story of this film. Justin Benson, who also directed and starred in this, wrote this script. And man, to take a concept in a universe from what they had in one of their first films in Resolution and just wanna continue with it from a different perspective, even not seeing Resolution, this film tells an amazing story that keeps you engaged from beginning to end to try and figure out what is actually going on. And it is well executed.
They definitely did a great job with it because I was a little nervous. I was hesitant about this one because there's very abstract imagery surrounding this movie, any screenshot in the poster. And just having seen Spring, you know, as kind of that's Lovecraftian, this actually kicks off with a Lovecraft little quote at the beginning, and I'm like, oh shit, what are we getting into? Is it gonna be another movie like Mandy, Void, Baskin, something that we don't understand, that we can't really properly review? No, it's actually very well done. Yes, there is the unknown, and there's stuff that you're trying to figure out, and you don't necessarily get all of the answers, but the characters are really, really enjoyable, and the story kind of moves at a fairly fast pace despite the long runtime, and you're going to have a pretty decent time trying to figure it out yourself. Who's lying? Who's the bad guy? You don't really know. And as the story progresses, more and more secrets are revealed, and we can't really talk about some of the cooler aspects of this movie because they come kind of closer to the end, but there are some pretty interesting twists. Or maybe just concepts, I guess.
The acting overall is very well done. Every single person in this film is believable, and they show a wide range of characteristics and personality traits because you're trying to figure out what is actually going on, and are these people at this camp really a part of a cult? And they showcase some stuff that makes them seem like they are a crazy cult member, but at the same time, they're just normal people, and their interactions are very natural.
Another highlight of this film, which is one that I actually expected, was the cinematography being excellent. Aaron Moorhead, also co-director and actor, is a cinematographer for this film. So, like, they wear a lot of hats, but the movie looks beautiful. Everything is really shot well. You see, like, a lot of landscape shots. There's a lot of drone photography, so you can kind of, I don't know, it's just kind of like the compositing and the way that shots are done are really great. And closer to the end of the film, you kind of figure out why, and everything makes a little bit more sense. It's just a really great looking film.
The color tones and the contrast, just visually, this is a beautiful film. Just to sit back and take in the scenery, take in everything that's going on, it's very nice to look at.
It's tricky to talk about a lot of this movie because there's a huge aspect of the film that is kind of a spoiler if we were to talk about it, so we can't, but I guess the soundtrack throughout the whole film is excellent as well. All of the music basically just serves its purpose depending on the situation. You can feel emotional at times. There's also a lot of upbeat moments, which I was actually surprised with, which helps with the flow of the film. When you see Lovecraft, you're like, oh boy, this is just gonna be something we gotta think about a lot. But you don't. It's easy to digest, and it helps because the characters are funny. These two brothers are joking around. There's other characters that are introduced throughout the film, like Shitty Carl. If you've seen the team's previous films, there's always a character, Shitty Carl.
And it really makes you wanna actually go out and see Resolution if you haven't seen it yet. You can still watch this film without seeing it, but the concept of Resolution is the two characters, Mike and Chris, that you see later on in the film. They're in this cabin not too far from the campground, and considering that you see where they are now, it makes you want to know what actually took place 10 years ago. And if you've seen Resolution and then watched this film, you're just sitting there being like, man, it's so cool seeing these characters again in another movie.
Now, what didn't we like? The only thing that I think is really noticeable about this movie, and not all the time, is some of the special effects, or the visual effects, sorry. There are some great visual effects because, like I said, I can't spoil anything, but there's things that happen in this movie that require visual effects. But at the same time, there are also things that they're not the greatest. And you can see like some poor compositing. Very nitpicky because at the point where you're gonna see the bad stuff, everything's been pretty good, so you're not gonna have too much of an issue. And I don't have much of an issue, but this is a section we've created, so I have to say something. Now it's time for our final thoughts and ratings. The Endless was an excellent movie. It's really difficult to find a fault. From the acting, the story, and the way that everything unraveled, I thought it was extremely well done. The cinematography is great, and it's just a really nice looking film that can have a deeper story if you continue to look into it, but it's easy to digest, and I think a lot of people will enjoy it. I'm starting to think that these guys can do no wrong. They just make quality things. Although, there was that weird instance, which I'm gonna use for my rating item right now, which is gonna be 5, cooking a Mr. Noodles or ramen on a stovetop in a pot? Who the hell does that out of 5?
It's true, there isn't a lot of negatives you can say about this film. The story makes you think. It gets you involved. It has you wondering what is real, what is actually going on. You kind of get those answers by the end of it, but when you're done, you still are trying to search for some answers you don't get. The characters are natural, they're believable. Every single person is a great actor in this movie. It's beautifully shot, it sounds great. I really loved this movie. So with that being said, I'm gonna give this film 5 giant locks out of 5.
As always, thank you for watching. Like this video and comment below with your thoughts on the film if you've seen it. If you haven't and you do want to check it out, there are links in the description where you can find it. And if you want the opportunity to recommend a movie for us to review, check out the links to our Patreon, first link in the description. And if this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe to the channel to stay updated with everything Bloodbath and beyond.